Welcome students to this new class and with this class we will be starting module number 3, in which you will see that it is unsteady state viscous flow, or you can say that it is time dependent flow of Newtonian fluids. And in your book you will find this this topic in chapter number 4. If you want to see this topic, you will find this here. So first I would like to discuss about two types of flows. That is, first is steady state flow, or you can say steady flow. What we have written here, that is okay, unsteady state. Then we can say here steady state flow. And number two is unsteady state flow. So all of you know this what these flows are. In this type of flow that up to now we have done, that is the flow that was through that tube as we saw, in which at any point if you will measure the velocity, it will not change with time. If you are taking a point here, its velocity is this, then you will see that with time it will not change. And in this type of flow, the velocity, if your flow is through this tube, and any point if you are taking here, then the velocity will take will change with time. Any moment it will be this, then we will find that it will become this much, and again it will change. So this is what time dependent flow means. So here you will see that your velocity will change with x, y, z, that is the spatial coordinates, and time also. In previous lectures, in chapter 2 and 3, we saw that velocity was changing only with space, only with these coordinates, like this here, this direction, or in this direction. So only with x, y, z. But in this chapter, you will see that we will take the case when the velocity will change with time also. So for that purpose we will take example number 4.1 of the book. Example number 4.1, this example we will be discussing here, and also in your syllabus also, if you will find that you need to discuss this flow. So this is your module 3, and unsteady state viscous flow and flow near a wall suddenly set in motion, boundary layer theory. So in example 4.1.1 you will see this topic. So in a way this your example number 4.1.1 deals with this concept, time dependent flow of Newtonian fluids, and also the same thing is this also, unsteady state viscous flow. So I would like to tell a few things about this flow. So up to now in chapter 2 and 3 we saw that our flow was changing only with position. So you saw there that there was no use of partial differential equations. But here you will see that our velocity and parameters will change with position and time. So you will see that there will be use of partial differential equation, or you can say that the flow will be described by partial differential equations. And after then, when we will develop that flow, or we will develop the mathematical expression of that flow in form of partial differential equations, then we are supposed to solve those partial differential equations. So obviously we need to know how to solve these partial differential equations, and actually this chapter uses three methods to solve partial differential equation. First method, in this chapter you will see that the method of combination of variables. In this method, you will, what you will do, that you will combine all those variables and form one single variable. For example, x, y and t. If there are three variables, then you can combine them and make a single variable, for example eta. And number two method, that you will see here if you will read this chapter, method of separation of variables. As the name suggests, in this we convert the partial differential equation into two or more ordinary differential equations, and then we separate the variables, and after then we can get the solution of that. And number three method is the method of sinusoidal response. And this solution is useful for in which there are kind of periodic inputs you are giving from outside to the system. So anyways, you know, our example number 4.1, we will use this method. So now we will concentrate upon this method, and first of all let me show you the example. This is the example 4.1-1, flow near a wall suddenly set in motion. So this is the example, a semi-infinite body of liquid with constant density and viscosity is bounded below by a horizontal surface. So I am showing you just this example here. This is your fluid, this is fluid, and this is the plate and wall. They are saying it is a wall, and at time when you have started the experiment, that is the time is less than 0, that time it is at rest, and at 0 you started the experiment and you suddenly bring the wall into motion at velocity v naught. So at that moment the scene will be this: fluid will be at rest, and you will see the wall at motion. But after then, as the time increase, you will see that the particles of fluid will get that momentum of the wall, and they will start moving along with the wall. So the molecules that are adjacent to the wall, they will have more velocity, and the molecules that are far away from this, they will have less velocity, and the velocity will change this way. You can see that the molecules that are on the wall, that are having the same velocity of the wall, and then the velocity is decreasing. So in this you will see that with time this profile will change. You are seeing this curve, and after then after some time you will see a different curve here. Even this curve can come up to here, and then ultimately after a long time has passed, you will see a straight line, and after then this curve will not change. So we have to get this curve in mathematical form. This is the actually aim of this section. So everything you can read from here, there is not much data into it. Everything I have told you, the only data is that the wall is at velocity v naught, and now you have to find the velocity vx as a function of y and t. That is the velocity, this is your in x direction, so that is the velocity vx. This is velocity vx, and you have to get its function with respect to y and time. So only this way it will change, and the velocity will change with respect to this direction and the time. And they are saying that there is no pressure gradient or gravity force in x direction, and the flow is presumed to be laminar. So in this what we do in this chapter, in this kind of problems, that first we postulate that what kind of velocity will be there, and they have actually already given to you, but if it is not given, then you can guess that the velocity will be in what direction the velocity will be there. So we have found that only vx velocity will be there, and it will be function of y and t. As you can guess from here, there will be no vy velocity in the y direction, there will be no velocity in z direction. Now based upon this postulation, we will go to the table that I had introduced to you in last classes, and from there we will get the equation. So first we are going to the table B.4. So this is the table in appendix B, and we will be having means we will be using equation of continuity this and this. So we are going to table B.4. B.4 is just mass balance, and you don't need that much here, because you have to just balance it. You have to just put your data here. This is your, this equation you will use, Cartesian equation of continuity, Cartesian equation you will use. Then if you will apply your data into this equation, you will find the density is not changing with time, then it is zero, and it is zero, this is zero, this is zero, and after then we will find that with the x, you will find that del vx over del x is equal to zero. So that is true, and this way your equation of continuity will satisfied. It will tell you that your system, whatever postulation you have made, it is okay. And but it will not give you any kind of equation, it will just give you that your mass balance is correct. And after then we will go to the table number B.5 is this, and here you can see that this is actually in terms of stress. We will go to the equation that will give you directly velocity. So we are coming to the B.6, and because that is the velocity vx, so we will take only first equation. This equation, second equation is of no use, and this equation of no use. And after then, when you will apply the data or customize this equation, you will find that this velocity, this is zero, this term is zero, because vy is zero, vz is zero, so this term is zero, pressure we are not taking into consideration, zero, because our system is very thin, it is just a plate moving on some fluid. Then you will see that this term will exist, this term is zero because vx, and this term will zero, this term zero, and this term will exist. This term will not exist because velocity is not changing with z. This term will be zero because they are saying that in x direction there is no gravitational. So only term that we are having here now is only term, it is I think this term, first term is there and this term is there. So only two terms we are having there. So now you take this equation from here, and if you will put all those terms equal to 0 that we have just discussed, you will find this only. That is the left side, we saw that only first term was there, and in the left right hand side we saw that only this term is here. All terms were 0, that's why we have written it this way. And here you see that this nu has come here. It has come because this rho is here and nu is here. So if you will divide mu by rho, then you will get that kinematic viscosity nu. So this way we have got this equation of our motion. So in this example you can again see that how we have used the table. We have not done any cell balance or kind of thing. We have just used the table directly, and directly we have got the equation. And now you can see that we have got the partial differential equation. So how to solve it? We will use the method of combination of variables. So what is that method? First of all, what do you do? First of all, you can define the conditions, boundary conditions and initial condition. In case of time dependent flow, there will be an initial condition also. It means that at t is equal to 0, what was the velocity? So at t is equal to 0 or less than 0, the velocity was 0. As you can see here, at t is equal to 0, velocity is 0 here. It started at t is equal to 0, v naught. Or you can say that v naught is the velocity of the wall actually. It is not the velocity of the fluid. So fluid particles are right here at the moment. Just the motion has just started, they will be static at here. So velocity is 0 of the fluid. We are concerned, we are dealing actually with the velocity of fluids, not velocity of wall. That's why it's 0. And boundary condition, just at the plate, and it is at the time when motion has started. So there the particles that are just near the wall, just at the wall, they are having v is not velocity, and the particles that are away, very far away from the wall, they will be having velocity 0. So we have put all these things here, and now here comes the important thing, because in combination of variables you will always convert your main variable, that is the velocity we are interested, you will convert it into dimensionless velocity. And you can do it by dividing the instantaneous velocity with the velocity that is here, that is constant velocity, that is of the wall. Any velocity that is constant, you can divide it. So they have defined it phi. Now after then we have got in this equation we have found this, we have converted into phi, and after then this remaining here, how you will convert these variables? Variables remaining are t and y, these are all to be combined in one variable actually. And also what do you see, that the new variable phi, here also you can define the initial conditions or boundary condition, or you can combine these conditions, and you can see that when you will combine these conditions into phi, you will see that at y 0 phi is 0, and at 0 t it is 1, and at infinite t it is 0. So this way I have introduced this example to you. You can read this example here, and how they are solving the this partial differential equation. In the next class I will give more explanation to you. For today class I think I should end the class now. Meanwhile, you can read this example from the book, because enough introduction has been given to you. So thank you very much.